Okay, I'm back with a new video and another toy is about to die. At least I can make this video and I don't want to type it all down using my smartphone. So, you asked me if I would like to look into your life as a Neanderthal. And what I found was something that I would call pre-Neanderthal. I was looking for you and I was just, you know, traveling your timeline. And the very first spark of what is you was living inside a creature that was older than a Neanderthal. Because the real ones I saw sitting in a open area somewhere in the forest close to a cave. There was water. I could hear the water. It wasn't a river, more a forest stream. So let me go back, because this was kind of confusing. I went back, I looked for you, found you, and you were standing in the dark, sort of hidden between rocks and trees, bushes, and you were way bigger than a normal Neanderthal. Very hairy. I thought you were just a big man. A big male with something like a cloak of bear hide or wolf hide or something like that, but it was your fur or something. Then I thought about werewolves, but I could, you know, eliminate that and throw that off my list. I could throw Neanderthal off my list. I saw you, and the only thing that popped up in my mind as true was pre-Neanderthal. And you were looking at a... That's the toy completely ruined. I am so... you were standing in the dark, caves, bushes, trees, big, way bigger, twice as big as the people or Neanderthal type that you were looking at, or, you know, you were hiding and sort of observing them. There were 7 females and 1 male. They were sitting around a fire in a circle, and they were, the male was sort of closer to the cave and the women were around the fire, and they were holding babies. 5 of these 7 were holding babies. And you were looking and you were looking, and then I was like, okay, I am probably on the wrong track here, so I'm just going to, you know, close this off and walk the dog. And we went to the forest and she was running around, and I sat down on a rock forest stream to get myself into the right state of mind. And you were still there. But this time you approached these ladies when the male Neanderthal went into the cave to do something. And you sort of sneak up on them and stole one of their babies. And you were sort of putting it on your back in some kind of cloth that you had made yourself, something furry. Okay, this is so confusing. It was confusing. I know it's confusing for you. It was extremely confusing for me to see a being, you, that was humanoid, human-like, but something that was there before the Neanderthal came into existence. you were hairy, big, twice as big as these people, Neanderthal people, and you stole one of their babies. You put it into a cloth, put it on your back, and just took off. And the ladies were screaming and scared, and for some old reason, the man in charge just didn't show up to help or whatever. And they let you go with one of their babies and screaming, confused and shocked. And, nobody tracked you down or hunted you or followed you, or you just disappeared into the dark. Now I came back and I was like, you're a nice guy, so I must be wrong. I sat down and I saw the same thing, you in the dark, glowing eyes, looking at those women, seeing the man, the only male, disappear into the cave, waiting till the women were around the fire, holding their babies and breastfeeding them, and you know. And I saw the same thing and I was like, okay, that's what I saw. I can't make something different out of it, so that's it. And then I wanted to write you a message because I couldn't see more or didn't find more information. But you came back and stole another one. And then you came back and stole another one. So, at the end, you left with 4 or 5, I think, all of the babies. I didn't see little children, like toddlers or whatever. Now this reminds me of, I'm going on a sidetrack now, when a lion, a male lion, has cubs with his pack, all the female lions, lionesses, and a new alpha male chases away the old alpha, the new alpha male kills all the children that the lionesses have. So that's what I thought about, that the only male that was in the cave replaced an older male and killed all the babies and made new ones, because all the babies were sort of the same age, between 3 and 7 months or so. You took them, you went away, and at that point the male Neanderthal came out of the cave and threw a spear at you, killing one of the babies. You didn't scream or fight back or whatever, you just kept walking. And one of these babies was dead, hit by a spear. There was dripping blood on the floor. It was still dark. I could smell the earth. I could hear insects and things like that. And that's when I thought, I really have to be wrong, because, you know, I like you. You're a nice guy. But I saw you with all these babies in a cloth walking away, and you went to your own area where you, I thought, you took the babies to slaughter them and kill them, because when that spear, Neanderthal, male Neanderthal, the only one, threw that spear, hit it, one of his own babies, and you just, you know, you ignored the whole thing and kept walking, I thought, maybe you're going to eat them, right? That makes sense. You just steal babies, you take them, you go to your own place and you, you know, eat them one by one or something. That was not the case. I saw you raise these babies till they were young, toddlers, and grown-ups, sort of grown-ups. And at some point, you had your own clan. And then it hit me, you were the last of your kind. I'm not saying that you weren't a Neanderthal, but what I saw was pre-Neanderthal. And you created your own clan because you were the last one of your species. And you were alone and you didn't want to die alone and live alone. And so you took these babies, raised them all by yourself, feeding them blood. And some water with herbs and things like that. And at some point, you had sex with one of your adopted children, and she was 12. And you had a child which was deformed or disabled, handicapped. You tried again and again, and all these babies, by the way, were female women, and you raised them and you tried to have babies with them. And at some point, there weren't any stillborns anymore. The child that was happy and healthy and perfect and intact and, you know, sort of normal, also hairy, little boy. And later on, by the way, you had a little girl, and at some point I felt that you knew you were going to die, and you buried yourself, as in you used some kind of stick or wood, you dug your own grave in the ground somewhere under three trees. You started digging and digging deeper and deeper, and you buried yourself. And you weren't afraid. I am pretty sure, I am almost 100% sure that you knew that you were the only one left. And once your children started helping you, being covered in dirt, this spark of you, your soul, your true self, or whatever you want to call it, jumped over onto two children. Now I see a graveyard filled with children of you that were not meant to live or were unlucky to, you know, survive birth or grow up and be healthy. And I still, the stupid thing is that I keep seeing the same thing. And I can't change it. Even if I say that I'm wrong or believe I'm wrong and I made a mistake or I should take a better look or whatever, I see the same thing happen again. I see you lying in your grave, you take your last breath, and with that breath, you spirited two of your children. So I'm going to upload this video, and if you want me to look deeper into it, then let me know. See you next time. Bye.